kids. Yeah, it's me, Buzz Lightyear. And I'm a-hearing that you're going to be out of school for a little bit. So me and one of my dear friends wanted to have a little Bible study with you today. We're going to call it Kids Corner. You're going to recognize who it is. Won't you welcome Sheriff Woody?
Howdy, partners. Howdy, partners. Good to be here with Buzz.
The reason I brought old Sheriff Woody out here today is this. Woody has a string that hangs out of his back. And what I'm a-hearing is that when you pull that string, whatever's in Woody's heart will come out of his mouth.
That's right, Buzz. And they've been pulling my strings for years. And listen, most of the time I say things like, there's a snake in my boot. There's a snake in my boot. But now, during this coronavirus, I've been paying more attention and doing more studying in the Bible. And I'm thinking when you pull that there string, it's going to be a little different this time.
Woody, that's a good practice, studying the Bible. Yeah. Hey, kids, how about we pull Woody's string and see what he's been learning in the Bible? Do you mind, Woody?
I guess. Go ahead, go ahead.
Here we go, kids.
No weapon formed against me shall prosper.
That was good, wasn't it? Here we go. Watch this, kids.
I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me.
Oh, that was a good one.
One more time. One more time. Here we go, kids. Watch.
I'm more than a conqueror through him that's loved me. Hey, how about that? Isn't that good?
It was stored right up there in his heart. Kids, get your Bibles right now. We're going to do a little Bible study, okay? And we're going to go to Matthew chapter 12 today. And we're going to read verses 33 through 35. Not all of it, but some parts of it. But I want to ask you a couple of questions. What if we all had a string on our back? Mm. And what if people pulled our string? What would be coming up out of our heart? Mm. I'm wondering today, what is going to be stored up in your heart that would come out of your mouth?
Good.
Would it be good or would it be bad? Let's see what the Bible says about this subject, okay? Matthew 12, verse 33 says, a tree is identified by its fruit. If a tree is good, its fruit will be good. If a tree is bad, then its fruit will be bad. For whatever is in your heart determines what you say. A good person produces good things from the treasury of a good heart, and an evil person produces evil things from the treasury of an evil heart.
Hey, kids, let old Sheriff Woody ask you, what's your heart full of? Why, you've got all this extra time there being out of school. Is your heart full of good things or bad things? What kind of music are you listening to? What's on your phone? What's on your social media? What are you watching on Netflix and YouTube? Is it good or bad? Because it's coming right in down all the way to your heart. It's something to think about, isn't it? Remember, whatever you put in your heart, your mind, hey, it'll come out in your mouth and in your life.
Amen, that's right, Woody. Partner. Hey, I got another verse here. I like Psalms 119, verse 11. It says, I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. Oh, wow, that's powerful. You know what? I'm wondering, Woody, what scriptures have you memorized? What are stored up in your heart that you could share with the kids today?
Well, some that come to mind are Psalms 23 and verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me.
Ooh, amen.
I'm reminded when Jesus said that he would never leave me nor forsake me. And then the third one is he said he'd go with me all the way, even to the end of the world.
Oh,
so he's going to be with us, partners.
That is awesome, Woody. Wow. I have a couple of verses that I really like, a couple of passages of scripture. One's in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not into your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your paths.
Amen.
But my all-time favorite, and it's a lot of people's favorite, John 3:16.
Yeah.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son,
Jesus,
that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus died on the cross for our sin. Isn't that awesome,
buddy? Oh, it's awesome. It's amazing. And I'm glad I'm partners with Jesus.
Amen, Woody.
Hey, kids, listen. Woody and Buzz have a challenge for you. Why don't you, over the next few weeks, with all this extra time, why don't you see how many Bible verses you can memorize? That way, when you need them later on, when things come up, they'll be right in your heart, and you can pull them right out. Hey,
what a great challenge. Hey, and I also challenge you, why don't you ask your parents what their favorite Bible verses are? Get some of theirs and try to remember them as well. Ask them for help. Hey, but listen, as we close this Bible study, remember, you have a friend in me and Woody, but you have a friend in
Jesus.
See y'all.
See you, partners.
Bye.